Good morning, children. Welcome back to the social session. Children, in the previous lesson, we have tried to understand about the different kinds of revenue systems introduced by the Britishers and by the Nizams. So it was under the landlords and tenants under British and the Nizams. Right from the Mughal period, we have seen some intermediaries like Jamindars who used to collect the land revenue and remit a little part, major part to the king or to the government, and they used to keep with them for their charges as a little amount. If 100 rupees is collected, 90 rupees is deposited to the government and 10 was kept by these people in order to look after the band of soldiers and in order to make the charges for collection. And we learned that it was in 1793, the British government, after British has come into power, we slowly understood that in order to finance their wars and in order to finance their trade activities across the continents, they started increasing the land revenue, which has ruined the agriculture in the country. And they also started spreading awareness about the cash crops than on the food crops. That also has led to the famine conditions. So now we shall understand what was the result of the system which has been introduced after 20 years of debate by Lord Cornwallis. It was in 1793, Lord Cornwallis has introduced a system called as a permanent settlement system. What is the system called as, children? Permanent settlement system. Under this system, the jamindars will participate in an auctioning. It's an open auctioning, okay? So as you find the auctioning of the players in IPL, this is also an open auctioning. So as it is agreed between the government and by the jamindar, that fixed amount has to be paid by this jamindar, and that is permanently, whether there is a good crop or a bad crop, whether it is a famine or a good year, you have to pay the same amount. So this kind of system is called as a permanent system, or otherwise it is pre-agreed between the jamindar and the government. It is called as a jamindari system also. But there are many negative results because of implementing the permanent settlement system. What is the result of this permanent settlement system? Let us see today. The fact is that the company officials very soon discovered that many of these jamindars were not investing in the improvement of the land. Why jamindars will invest? Jamindars will not show any kind of interest in improving the conditions on the land. And in fact, the revenue that had been fixed was so high that jamindars found it very difficult to pay, and there were no remissions even during the period of a bad year or during the period of crop failure. There were no remissions from the side of a jamindar. And numerous jamindars had sold off. They were unable to pay the agreed revenue, say they had sold off their jamindari in auctioning system, and they were rapidly replaced by the new jamindars. And in fact, as a result of this, there was a lot of instability in the villages, and the old jamindars were rapidly replaced by the new jamindars. By 1820, the situation gradually, slowly started changing. The price of the grains started gradually increasing. As it started rising up, the cultivation slowly expanded. As a result, this meant that the income of the jamindars had increased. But it did not resulted in the increase of revenue for the Britishers, because the settlement system which they have introduced was a permanent settlement. They cannot increase the revenue. This has increased only the revenue of the jamindars, but not the company's revenue. Even then, the jamindars were not interested in improving the land conditions. Some had lost their land earlier. So in order to replace them, or in order to compensate that lost land in the earlier years, now they have saw this opportunity as earning. And without any trouble and without any risk of investing, they started earning more in the name of rent. And revenue was less, and rent was high. As long as jamindars could not give out the land to the tenants and get rent, they were not interested in improving the conditions of the land. So they started renting the land at a higher cost. than the revenue. As a result of that, Jamindars has become very rich and a very nominal amount was paid to the government. So there was no increase of revenue to the government. Population was increasing rapidly on the other hand, and the Jamindars had kept on evicting the peasants in order to meet their demands of a high rent, and their lands were given to the new ones at a higher rent. As a result of this, on the other hand, in the villages, the cultivators had found the system extremely oppressive because they had been evicted from their land, which is being cultivated from generations together, and the rent they paid to the Jamindar was so high and their right on the land was also very insecure. This had created a kind of oppressive environment in the village. And they had to take loans even in order to pay the rent, and the loans were given in the form of money lenders by the same Jamindar. So these money lenders, what they used to do is, if the farmers failed to pay the interest or they failed to pay the rent, then immediately their land was, the farmers were evicted from their land and their land was taken over by these Jamindars, which they had cultivated for generations. So during this period, by the early 19th century, what happened, many of the company officials had found that they were not convinced with the system which was in practice till then. So they wanted to increase the revenue. But how can they increase the revenue which has been fixed permanently? In order to meet their expenses, which has been increasing from year to year. So the districts of, during the same period, the districts of Bellary, Anantapur, Kadapa, Karnool, these districts which were under the control of Nizam had been handed over to the Britishers because he unable to maintain the British contingent. As a form of debt, he has handed over these four districts, which we call them as Rayalaseema, back to the British. So the British government has appointed one collector called as Thomas Munro. Thomas Munro was appointed as a district collector of these districts. What are those districts? Bellary, which is presently in Karnataka, okay, Anantapur, Karnool, and Kadapa. These are the four districts which were handed over to the Britisher by the Nizam government because Nizam unable to maintain the contingent in his kingdom. So it was in November 1800 he was appointed as a collector of these districts. At that time, these ceded districts had a problem of palegars. Palegars, they own a small band of soldiers, and there was a lot of anarchy which used to take place. Violence. Anarchy is nothing but violence in these districts. So it was the first Britishers wanted to clear these palegars, and they had completely disassociated their armored soldiers, their armored followers, whoever was there, they had completely disbanded them, and these palegars were brought under control. And after that, Munro commenced his work of surveying the land. Survey of the land for the first time started by Thomas Munro, and he started fixing a revenue settlement. So it was, and he realized in his survey that the Jamindari system which was in practice in North India, the same kind of practice was not present in the South India. In South India, most of the peasants own the land and they were not like Jamindars. So it was a close-knitted peasant families which are present, peasant communities which are present in Andhra and Tamil region, unlike in North India. So recognizing the importance of these peasants, he introduced a system called as Raitu Wari system. The system introduced by Thomas Munro is called as Raitu Wari system. Raitu Wari system means Rait is nothing but peasant. Farmer. Wari, Raitu Wari means peasant tenure system it is called as. So he introduced that system called as the Raitu Wari system, and under this system, what kind of a mechanism he proposed? So Later, the same system got spread in the entire South India and even in the western part of India. So, Raitu is nothing but a cultivator, a peasant, and Raitu Wari means a peasant tenure system. And it was decided that the collection of revenue from the actual cultivators or the owners of the land will be made, either worked on the land themselves or got the land on the rent, has to pay the tax. And under this settlement, the peasants cultivating the land were originally identified, and the field was given a survey number. They were even given the survey number. So the surveying of the land was first time done by Thomas Munro, and he has given a survey number to all the people who were cultivating, original cultivating. And the yield, price situation, the conditions of the pricing, the market condition, the crop cultivated, they have taken all these things into account to decide what is the tax per acre. Then, but before that, cultivation commenced in 1801 and 1802. What he did is, he has extended some kind of subsidies to them. He extended loans to them to purchase the seeds, to purchase the implements, to purchase the bullocks. He extended loans, and that year the country has seen a bumper crop, due to which the settlement system was considered as a successful system, and it was implemented not only in South India but in the entire India. They started implementing the Raituwari system. As a result of this, even the people like Sir Arthur Cotton started arguing in the government that government has to invest a lot of money in order to provide the irrigational facilities to the cultivators. So in the next class we shall understand how these government has taken up big irrigational projects and made some of the famine hit areas into agriculturally prosperous areas. Thank you, children.